Hello, this is Nicole Spohr for Spellbinders. Today I'm sharing this Inking White Die Cuts Ocean Scene card with you. Everything on this card was die cut from white cardstock and then inked. I'm using the following dies to create my interactive card today. The Nest Abilities Scored and Pierced Rectangles Etched Dies, the Shape Abilities, Die Delights, Sea Animals, and the Sea Life Accents. We're gonna start by die cutting our background, which I was just showing you from the largest Nest Abilities Scored and Pierced Rectangles die collection. This was die cut from some Bristol Smooth cardstock. Then I am going to die cut the Sea Life Accents border, and then the fish, the jellyfish, the crab, and the fish, the rest of the little fish fin from Bristol Smooth cardstock. And I'm just using scraps of Bristol Smooth cardstock. Then I'm going to temporarily adhere these in place, flip this over, and go ahead and emboss these. These all have embossed areas on them that are really going to pick up the ink. This is one of my favorite things about this technique of die cutting all of these individual pieces from smooth white cardstock and adding my own ink. Anything that is raised or embossed or debossed is going to hold that ink, meaning especially for when we get to coloring like the jellyfish, you'll definitely see it, the little spots on top of the jellyfish. We're going to ink the jellyfish with pink, but those little spots on its head, we're going to add some blueprint sketch on that, and it's really just going to pick up that color and concentrate that there. Once I have all of my pieces die cut, and I'm going to do multiples, I think it really kind of helps reinforce the look and feel of the scene and really fills my ocean with lots of cute critters by adding multiples to my card. So instead of one fish and one jellyfish and one crab, there's actually going to be four fish, three jellyfish, and one crab. You could also use any combination of the critters. I think the only guy I didn't use from this is the octopus, but I think he would be cute too. Part of the reason I chose not to use him on this card is I had looked through my crafty stash for a sentiment that would work with this die collection, and I picked a My Favorite Things stamp set. The greeting reads, "I'm so jelly, but super happy for you," which I think works so well with the cute jellyfish images, and so I decided to concentrate more on them. When you're creating a card, always be conscious of trying to reinforce the theme with your sentiment. In this case, the jelly sentiment really works well with those jellyfish. Next, we're going to take that scored and pierced rectangle and start inking it up. This is going to be my ocean scene background. I'm using shaded lilac, blueprint sketch, and black soot distress oxide inks. These inks are going to blend beautifully, especially on this Bristol Smooth cardstock. I'm going to just keep working those inks together until I get a beautiful seamless transition, and then I'm going to spritz this whole thing with water from a distress sprayer. Now, finger marks will show up in this, so usually I try to use a scrap piece of paper to hold this down so that I don't necessarily get my fingers in it. I didn't worry about it too much here. I'm going to blot those water droplets. I want to blot that dry, kind of set it aside for a minute, and then we're going to bring it back and add even more interest that's really going to reinforce these cute critters. This is a stencil collection from Honeybee Stamps. I am using the Ocean Scene Builder, and we want those little light rays that filter through the water to show. So what I'm using is a white pigment ink pounced through this stencil. Instead of rubbing it, I'm doing more of a pouncing motion. Now, when I remove the stencil, you're gonna think it doesn't really look very good. I think it's too harsh. So what I like to do is take a dry paper towel, a dry rag, and just kind of buff those out. It's going to lighten them, and look how perfect those light rays are now coming down through the ocean. Then there is another stencil in this same collection that gives even more interest. And so I'm going to pounce that white Distress ink through this. Now I rubbed this off the same way I did the light rays, and I really felt like I lost a lot of the detail. Not all of it, but some. So I decided to go ahead and take my stencil, place it, line it back up, place it right back over, pounce that ink back in place. We're gonna do that in both areas. And then instead of rubbing it off, I'm going to blot it more dry instead. And I think that's going to work a lot better. It's still kind of buffing it, but it's not, and muting it a little bit, but you still get that definition. So there is the background all inked up on our Nestability scored and pierced rectangle background. Now we're going to take this awesome border, and this is going to go along the bottom edge of our rectangle, and ink this up with some forest moss and peeled paint distress oxide inks. And because this is such a more detailed area, I find that using some little sponge daubers works so much better for precise inking without having to mask anything off. Nothing I created today did I have to use a mask, which is a huge time saver. And these little inking tools work so great for this. So we're using a combination of two green colors for the green areas. And then everything else along that bottom edge, the little shells and everything, I just stuck to Gathered Twigs Distress Oxide ink to keep it a little bit easier. So this is kind of what it's gonna look like. Look how cute that looks along the bottom edge. You can definitely feel that ocean scene card starting to take shape. I'm gonna grab another Dauber Duo because that edge that meets the green, I really was a little bit concerned about using a larger ink blending tool. So just like I did for the seaweed, we're going to pounce on our color using Gathered Twigs. And I did more of a pouncing motion to begin with, which is kind of what I did for the seaweed as well. But then I do end up going back in and doing more of a traditional kind of ink blending type of motion where I'm swiping it on more than pouncing it. And any of those little embossed or debossed areas is going to pick up more of the ink. So here I'm just going to start blending that even more. Now, because I did die cut all of these from Bristol Smooth cardstock, it tends to keep the ink wet a little bit longer. The Distress Oxide inks by nature, because they have some pigment ink in them, do tend to stay wet a little bit longer. So I did buff some of this color off with a dry paper towel, but I felt like the seaweed especially got too light. And so I went back with my forest moss and added some deeper, darker color. And then I took my heat tool to this to dry the ink so that instead of losing that intensity, I'm just going to dry it in and speed up that drying process quite a bit so I can go ahead and adhere this border to the bottom edge of my background. And then I can move on to the jellyfish and the fish and the crab. I did use a little bit of the white over the brown just to kind of help accent some of the areas. I don't know that that showed up all that well. And then I went back with some more brown as well, just trying some different things, trying to figure out how I liked that bottom border the best. So here's that heat tool. And you can really see, I don't think it shows in the video as well, but in real life, you can definitely see that it's wet and you'll see it start to dry as you heat it. And that is how you know that you're not going to transfer ink, because when it's really wet like that, if you put your fingers in it and then touch something else, you will transfer the ink. So I always try to be really careful about that, because you don't want to transfer the green to the fish or your ocean background. Now for the jellyfish, I am using that combination of Worn Lipstick and Blueprint Sketch. As I mentioned earlier, those little dots that are embossed on the jellyfish's head are the perfect little spot that are going to pick up this Blueprint Sketch ink. And with the pink, it really gives more of a purple look and feel. I even touched a little bit of purple to the end of the jellyfish tentacles there. And then I'm just going to go back with pink and purple, just back and forth until I get that intensity and the color exactly the way I want. All three jellyfish are going to be colored exactly the same. They're going to add a nice pop of color. The crab I colored with candied apple distress oxide ink, stuck just to the candied apple. This is the one critter in this dye collection. I guess the octopus doesn't have eyes either, I don't think, that die cut out, that are more debossed. But the crab has debossed eyes. So when I inked him, the eye, the part of that didn't capture the ink. So I'll go back with a black pen in a little bit and add some detail for his eyes. My fish are all a combination of wild honey and spiced marmalade distress oxide inks. I do want to mention that I did not show it in the video, but you will notice it in the photos at the beginning of the video and at the end of the video, that all of the fish feature a little fin. That is an extra die cut piece that I did die cut and ink up. I didn't do it right at the beginning because I knew I was going to add some texture to the fish or some scales with Nuvo Crystal Drops. And because of that, I needed those to completely dry before I added my fish fins, and I forgot to capture that on camera. So there is that little extra piece, which I think is phenomenal. Now you want to make sure your background is completely dry with all that inking we did if you're going to stamp and emboss directly on the background. And I stamped my sentiment with a clear embossing ink, sprinkled on white embossing powder, and then heat set that. If you don't have it dry before you do this, the embossing powder can stick to any of the ink that might still be wet. So we're ready to start putting it all together. I'm going to speed the video up just a little bit here, since this is simply adhering all of these little pieces. The border goes right along the bottom edge. I love how the little ocean border bottom here really just grounds the whole thing. We're going to tuck our little crab down there. I added the little black to his eyes to give his little face more detail. We're going to start adding our jellyfish. I do like to kind of lay things out before I commit to putting them anywhere so that I can make sure and know exactly where everything is going to go so that it all fits together perfectly. So I'm using some acrylic blocks to hold down anything that's glued in place. If I used liquid glue, sometimes it tends to curl up. So if I use an acrylic block, that kind of helps hold it nice and flat while that glue dries. And then I'm just adding some little fish here and there. One of the little fish is going to be kind of coming off of that left edge of the card. Some of the fish are in front. Some are swimming in between the seaweed. This just gives the scene so much more life, so much more interest, and really, really adds to the cute factor, I think, and the realistic underwater ocean scene of this card. Now, I did go ahead and take my jellyfish and fish and die cut them from some black cardstock, and I'm going to inlay little eyes into each of these critters. You could definitely maybe take some Nuvo Crystal Drops in black and add that for eyes instead if you don't want to do the additional die cutting. You could use a black pin. You could layer a piece of black cardstock behind instead of just like a little scrap piece that you trim out if you want to. You could add googly eyes or sticker eyes, jewels, all kinds of different things if you don't want to do the extra die cutting. And then the fun part of adding scales to these fish, I am using Nuvo Crystal Drops and English Mustard to add some little drops all over my fish that look like scales. These are teeny tiny little drops. They are all different sizes. And then I want to let those completely dry. Because these are so much smaller than what some Nuvo Crystal Drops are, they are going to dry really quickly. I don't think you have to probably let them dry the whole 24 hours or whatever. You definitely could, and I probably would recommend that before you try to mail the card, but they do dry much faster than if you do bigger droplets. So I'm doing this for all of my little fish. I think it adds so much character to them. And once that is completely dry, I will glue in place the little fish fin. Now, I thought I needed bubbles. There is some die-cut bubbles from the Sea Animals you could do, or I'm just taking Nouveau Crystal Glaze. Glossy Accents would work as well. This is a clear glaze that you can add, make your own little drops, and I am adding these all over the card to add to that underwater ocean type feel. I'm going to add some adhesive to a side fold card base, pop my panel right in place there, and that is going to finish up this underwater ocean scene featuring inking white die cuts with distress oxide inks. You could also use markers, you could use other types of inks, you could use colored pencils, watercolors, all kinds of different things. It is so fun to take all white die cut pieces and add your own color to them with whatever coloring medium you enjoy. If you have any questions about this card, please leave them in the comments below and be sure to subscribe to the Spellbinders YouTube channel for more instructional videos. Thanks so much for joining me today, and we'll catch you next time.